Hello, gang. Tattooed Biker here with you. And tonight, I've got four true cryptid encounter stories from all over the country to share with you. An upright, hairy cryptid in West Virginia, trolls in New York, an antlered humanoid in Minnesota, and, well, just something completely bizarre in California. This one is sure to make you wonder what all is really out there. So grab your gear and let's ride to Cryptid Country. Number 1. Hey Tattooed, I had a strange incident that happened in August of 2006 that continues to bother me because I have no explanation for it. I was living in Elkins, West Virginia at the time with my wife's parents. I used to go into the Dolly Sods Wilderness area a lot to go hiking and to just spend some alone time. I had heard stories about the Dolly Soda and that Bigfoot was in there. I never paid much attention to the stories. One late afternoon, I was in the low part of the Dolly Sods at the Red Creek. This area is really beautiful, but you can wander off the trail and easily get lost. It had started to rain, so I was heading back towards my truck. On my way, I noticed something big move out of some thicket about 50 yards to my left. I stopped to get a better look with my binoculars. I waited until I saw more movement and then aimed the binoculars in that direction. What I saw actually caused me to gasp. I could see it very clearly. It was a monstrous creature, standing at least 7 feet tall and had black hair all over. It was walking on two very strong legs that looked human. It had a very large chest, and the arms and hands were huge and even bigger than those of a very powerful man. I couldn't see the fingers because it was carrying some sort of vegetation. The head was huge and covered in thick hair, but its face had an odd-looking form. It was hard to make out since it was moving away from me, but the jawline extended out from the rest of the face. It continued to walk swiftly away from me, but in the same direction where the truck was parked. I didn't know what to do, and so I kind of stood frozen for several minutes. I started to quietly walk toward the truck when I hear something crashing through the thicket. I stopped and knelt down, but I couldn't see anything. Well, by then I'd had enough and I wanted to get out of there. I started running towards the truck and made it there in about 10 minutes. I quickly drove away and went straight home. I never went back to the Dolly Sods. I'm now very wary of all things in the wilderness. I contacted a couple of wildlife experts who probably thought I was crazy. I'd never believed it if I hadn't seen it myself. One of these guys did say that there had been a wolfman reported in the area back in the 1870s and that he had personally talked to a few people who had claimed to see Bigfoot. To me, this wasn't a Bigfoot in my mind. Not long after that incident, we moved to Morgantown, West Virginia. I still enjoy hiking, but now I prefer to stay on the more pedestrian trails. Any idea what this could have been? Signed, Rick. Number 2. Hello, sir. My name is Dee, and I'd like to confide in you an experience I had in 1990 when I lived near Cooperstown, New York. It was mid-spring, and a girlfriend and I had decided to take a walk in the surrounding countryside. While we were taking a rest near a large outcropping of rocks, there was this humming sound coming from one of the nooks. My girlfriend stood and started walking towards the noise. Though it was late afternoon and we were in heavy tree cover, there was enough light to see into the rocks. As she got closer, she said that the sound was coming from inside one of the large boulders. I began to walk towards her and the boulder to have a listen for myself. We stood there for about 5 minutes, and that's when we noticed that the boulder seemed to start shimmering like water. We quickly stepped back as the shimmer grew and changed to a greenish hue. Then suddenly, two small beings emerged from the shimmering portal. These beings walked towards us as we tried to move away, but it's like we were paralyzed and unable to walk. These beings, they were about 3 feet in height and had green-colored clothes that looked like work overalls. The faces and body features were human-like, though I'd have to say more human children, but with some adult features. They also had long blonde hair and very dark, large, round eyes. Their hands had four distinct fingers and were very rough textured. This incident occurred much earlier in the film, but these beings reminded me of the Hobbits and the Lord of the Rings. I know that sounds nuts, but it's true. They took each of us by the hand and started pulling us towards the rock. We both quickly regained our ability to move. We broke away from their grasp and ran down the hill. As we ran, we could hear them running behind us. A minute or so into the chase, I felt something hit me on the back and realized that one of the beings had thrown a stone at me. I stopped and looked back, but they were gone. Although I could still hear their voices from a distance, that sounded like these were more of these beings, and these sounds were getting louder. We continued running until we reached the car, jumped in, and sped off. We had driven about a half mile when a piece of tree branch came flying out of the woods, hitting the side of the car. I looked up into the woods, but neither of us could see any signs of these strange beings. We were both shaking when we finally arrived home, and we agreed not to tell anyone about the incident, though I think she may have mentioned it to a friend years after we'd gone our separate ways, because there was talk about little people in the surrounding woods. I never had another encounter with these things, but I feel like they knew where I lived. One morning, I found a small pile of stones on my patio picnic table with four-fingered muddy handprint beside it. I recently moved out of the area, but I still have a feeling that they know where I am. Last week, I was leaving for work and walking out to my car. When I got to it, I noticed a reddish-colored four-fingered handprint on the windshield. I took a closer look, and then I realized that the handprint was made in blood. That evening, while sitting in my office at home, I heard voices outside. I looked out the office window, and that's when I caught a quick glance of something darting into the bushes next door. I continued to watch, but I never saw anything else. I have no idea what's happening, though I do know that I'm not imagining any of this. Is there a possibility of little beings, like hobbits, elves, or trolls living among us? I've never seen or read about any of this. It all just seems so crazy. Any ideas? Signed, D. Number 3. Hey TB, thank you for allowing me to send you my story. Every year, my 5 friends and I from high school, we make a trip up to my family's cabin in Itsca County, Minnesota, to spend the week drinking, fishing, playing cards, and getting into shenanigans. We started this tradition after our senior year of high school. We've kept it up ever since. The very first year that we all took a minivan from Arizona up to the lake, we would usually stop in Denver, Colorado for the first night, and then make the 17-hour drive up the lake the next day. On the second day of this drive, it was about 1 a.m. in the morning, and we were about an hour away from the cabin. It had just rained, and the road was extremely foggy, and we could hardly see 10 yards in front of the van. On that final stretch, we come around a corner, and we see a giant cross glowing in the distance. In that foggy lighting, with little to no sleep, and after 16 hours in the car, the sight of a cross in the distance was, well, ominous, to say the least. As we drive past the cross, we see a run-down, decrepit church, lit up by the light of the cross. My friends will deny it to this day, but I can swear that I saw a light turn on in that church as I drove past it, and in the window, I saw a human-like figure with antlers on its head. I wasn't that tired, and the long drive hadn't affected me. I was completely freaked out and wanted to get as far away from that church as possible, but couldn't drive away quickly because of the fog and the fact that deer were jumping onto the road every few minutes. We ended up eventually making it to the cabin safely, but every time I think back to that drive, I get chills. What do you think I saw? Signed, William. Number 4. Dear Biker, this happened the night of February 27th, 2017 in the early morning. I was staying at the Best Western in Big Bear. At approximately 12:35 a.m., I walked to my car alone to retrieve my luggage. It had been snowing and was extremely dark, and my car was facing a country road. When I hit the unlock button on my car, the parking and interior lights popped on. This allowed me to see two eyes reflecting in the middle of the road, about 10 to 15 feet away from me. At first, I thought it was a deer. Now, I've lived in Colorado, and I'm accustomed to seeing wildlife. I instantly stopped and remained still as I didn't want to scare off what I thought was a deer. As my eyes glanced downwards, I noticed that it wasn't a deer. In fact, it looked like a white, hairless, naked man down on all fours. It was at least 4 feet in height, probably around 15 feet if it stood up. There was a brief moment as our eyes made contact. It then, as quickly as I've ever seen any animal, turned around and ran as fast as a cheetah away from me, and then straight up a tree. I was frozen in disbelief. I yelled out loud to myself, "You gotta be kidding me." Just as I was going to convince myself that this couldn't possibly be happening, it leaped from the treetop to treetop, and I could see its full outline as it did so. Now, I've never heard of such a creature, but I have found some other videos and pictures online that looked exactly like what I saw. The speed and strength it had is like nothing I've ever heard of or seen before. The creature was definitely solid. It appeared as if it was coming towards me, maybe hunting me. I don't know what stopped it. Was it the lights that went on? It had no visible genitalia, and it had very human-like qualities. First, it was a new moon, and I believe it might have been an eclipse that day as well. There was a creek across the street, and I don't know if this has anything to do with my experience, but I was a day out from my period. If this had been a huge-eyed gray alien, it would have made more sense. I've heard of those, but this was unlike anything that I've ever been familiar with. None of this makes sense to me. The speed and agility of that creature. And there shouldn't be any way that the treetops should have been able to hold on the weight of something like that. It appeared to be flashing like a TV, going in and out of reception as it sprinted up that tree. It also didn't appear to disrupt the branches or leaves as it did so. I immediately called my dad after I rushed back to my hotel room. My son was asleep, and I was understandably in a state of shock. At that time, no one knew what hotel I was staying in. As I was crying on the phone with my dad, the hotel phone rang. I answered it, and it was only a dial tone. Then, there was a knock at the hotel room door. Once again, no one was there. At that point, my son woke up due to all the commotion. I told him it was just a scary dream. I gave my dad the hotel information, and he advised me to go wait in the lobby with my son. As we were leaving, there was another knock, but it was at the back sliding glass door that went out to a private, fenced-in patio. This was a one-time encounter, and it's unfortunate that I still live in fear of this experience. I was raised a Christian, and this humanoid doesn't fit into any category with which I am familiar. I don't know why this happened and what I'm supposed to be learning from it. In addition, the hotel phone number I found out later has 6 sixes in a row. I don't know if that has anything to do with what happened. I was always taught that demons can't have a physical body unless it's possessing someone. I can't imagine it flying a spacecraft due to its primal manner. Was this a transdimensional being? A Nephilim? What was it going to do? Is it going to come after me again? Why didn't it do what it was setting out to do the first time? My previous beliefs about the world and the way things work has been tossed upside down. While it's thought-provoking, it's been very traumatic and it's had me in a panic state that's distracting and mostly negative. Thanks for reading. Signed, Anonymous.
Quick editor's note here. For the past several years, I've been hearing about sightings of a humanoid in and around the Big Bear Lake area. From Southeast, Big Montero Canyon, along Route 62 into Yucca Valley, and Joshua Tree. There have been many reports of people going missing in this area over the years, and a few body parts have even been recovered. And there it is, all the true cryptid encounter stories I have for you this evening. So what were these things? I'm anxious to hear your thoughts about these in the comments below, but please, keep it respectful to the witnesses. And if you have a strange experience or an unexplained encounter that you'd like to share, just send it to the email address in the description and, well, your story may just wind up in a future video. Anyways, thanks for riding with me tonight. I really appreciate you. And until next time, stay curious, stay vigilant, stay safe, and I'll be seeing you on down the road a ways. Biker out.